Everyone, myself Abdul Basit. So in today's session, we are going to discuss about the Dr. Odin Felgam Suction Unit. So here you can see the brand name is Dr. Odin. So Dr. Odin Felgam Suction Unit, the model is H003. So this device is basically used for sucking the mucus inside our body. So basically, this is the oil-free lubrication suction device, which is usable, which is suitable for use by the patient who has difficulty in Felgam removal due to illness, coma, and operation, as well as for operating such liquids as pus and blood during the clinical practice. So it is a commonly applied medical device for use in the emergency room, operating room, and for nursing in sick room care, etc. So the characteristics and the working principle of oil-free lubrication pump is it is applied to keep the environment from being polluted by the oil mist. So then it has large plugs and low noise design. So it completely plastic panel design which have good waterproof quality. Then with overflow device to prevent liquid into pump. So it can adjust negative pressure according to your request. So let me explain the parts of the device. So here you can see this is the main device. So this is the main device. So this is the reservoir bottle. So it has the capacity of 1000 ml. So 1000 ml capacity of reservoir bottle. And then here we have the soft suction pipe. And then here we have the catheter. So here in this device we have two different sizes of catheter. So let me open this, then only you can able to see clearly. So here you can able to see. So let me put this aside. So you can able to see the different sizes of the catheter. So this is the largest size catheter for the adults. So the smaller size catheter for the babies like that. So the children above, the children below the age range of 12 and 10. So that type of patients can able to use this small size catheter. So this is for above 15 range of adults. We can able to use this large size catheter. Also we have the different filters. Air filters, extra air filters for this device. Now we can take the one air filter. So here we can able to see the soft pipe. So through this soft pipe only we can able to suck the mucus or the thick membrane, or the mucus can able to suck through this soft pipe. So here we have the three different sizes of soft pipe. So this one end we can able to connect the air filter between these two pipes. So it is connected. Now here you can able to see the two different knobs, two types of knobs. So one is to create the vacuum, the suction pressure inside the bottle, and the another one is for the patient. So this inlet is able to connect to the patient. So let me connect this. Yes. And then other end need to be connected to this port. So this is how we need to place the pipe. And here you can able to see. So this end has to be placed to this part of the reservoir bottle. In this end we can able to connect the catheter. Okay. So let me connect this. Yes. Fix tightly. So now let me explain you about this front part. So this is the indicator. So this is the on off switch. So this is the regulating knob. So through this knob only we can able to adjust the pressure. So how much of pressure given in the device can be able to see through this indicator knob. So the unit which we are able to measure the pressure is megapascal. You can able to see here MPa. So that is megapascal. Okay. So the low negative pressure is 0.02. So if we turn on the device and if we close the end part, it need to be come to the 0.02 MPa, which means the device is in good condition. If it exceeds the 0.02 level, or if it is below the 0.02 level, the device is in faulty condition. So we need to troubleshoot it. Okay. So let me connect this port to the power supply. So basically, normal 230 volt 50 hertz power supply is necessary. It's enough for this device to run. So let me connect to this port. So let me connect this power cord. So here you can able to see the turn on the off switch. So if you turn on, the device is starts. So if I close this end part, the device need to come to the 0.02 megapascal. So if it's come to 0.02, the device is in good condition. So you can able to see it is correctly in 0.02 negative pressure. So which means the device is in good condition. If it's below or if it's above that pressure, we need to troubleshoot the device. Which means maybe the fuse, this fuse or the air filter may be damaged, or this pipe, the soft pipe may be damaged, or else the motor inside the device, the compressor motor may be damaged. So that's how we can able to troubleshoot the device. Okay. So now I am turn on the device. So if I close it, at the starting level, the device has come to 0.02 megapascal. If I keep on increasing this regulating knob, the pressure will increase. So you can able to see, if I am increasing this regulating knob, according to that, the pressure will increase. So you can able to see here, I keep on increasing the knob, so the pressure also keep on increasing. Top level, the pressure also increases. So here you can able to see. So now you can able to understand how much the such and power of the device. Right? If I remove it, the pressure will come to zero again. Again, if we close this part, the pressure will increase. So keep on increasing. Hold this part. So because here we have the suction, so due to suction it is the pipe hold on my finger. So if I remove it, suddenly come to 0%. Okay, so now I am turning off. Now I am gonna connect this catheter part. Connecting this catheter. So this is how we need to connect this catheter to this soft pipe. Okay. So this catheter will go inside our mouth. So we can able to suck this mucus through like that. So the catheter part will be go inside up to this part. So up to this part, the catheter will go inside, which means the physician will insert this catheter to this till that part. So through this the physician or the doctors can able to suck the mucus inside our body. Okay. For the demonstration, I will show you with the water. So I'm going to turn on the device. when we are going to start the device, we need to keep the pressure in low. Then only afterwards we can able to increase slowly. Okay. So now I am gonna insert the catheter to the water. So you can able to see. So now you can able to see the water is, due to suction, the water is sucking through the catheter. So if I increase the suction power, the water level get suddenly increased. I think now we can able to understand clearly. So you can able to see here, if the device reaches the top level, if the device reaches the 1000 ml maximum capacity of this bottle, the automatically no suction will be present in the device and it will be get stopped, because I will show you the inner part of the device. Let me turn off the device. So inside the bottle, you can able to see some cylinder like structure is present here. So why? Because is if the particular liquid or the some substance reach the maximum level, the cylinder will get on close the this part. So due to that, no pressure will be present and the no suction bar will be present. So that's how the device will get stops automatically. So you can able to see here clearly, right? So this is how the device works. So now let me put this aside. Let's remove all the tubes. So I am gonna turn off the device. And now let me dismantle it and I will show you the internal parts of the device. It has a long screw, that's why they're taking a long time. So yes, I removed the upper part. So let me explain you. So here we have the compressor motor. So the motor is slightly hot because we run the device for 5 minutes. So here you can able to see the regulating knob and the pressure creating knob and the regulating the indicator knob. All these are interconnected. So here you can able to see inside. So here. So all these are interconnected. Why? Because is if we keep on increasing the regulating knob, at the same time the same pressure has to send through this part and the same pressure has to indicate in this indicator. That's why the four tubes are interconnected using this connecting. So here you can able to see. So the pressure is creating using this compressor motor. So there is nothing electrical components present here. So it's simply a mechanical part. So the compressor motor producing the compressor pressure. So that's why the pressure is produced here. So if we increasing this pressure using this regulating knob, the pressure will get increased. The same pressure will be indicated through this indicator part. So indication will be measured in megapascal. Okay. So indicator will be indicated in megapascal with the on and off switch, regulating knob. Once again, I will tell you the regulating knob, the suction unit, the indicating knob, the turn on off switch. Okay. So let me place this correctly. Yes. So the compressor motor. So the fan is used to suck the air and so for the clear explanation I will turn on the device and I will show you clearly. So now I am going to turn on the device. So here you can able to see the device is running. So there is nothing electrical components present here. Only the keep on giving the power supply, turn on the device. After that the device starts to run. So through this only the suction pressure will be created here. So here you can able to see I am closing this part, so the pressure will be indicated here. Right? Now I am gonna keep on increasing the regulating knob. Which means I keep on increasing the pressure will get increased. I think you can able to understand clearly now, right? So I reduced the pressure. Now I am going to increase it. So note the pressure value. So note the pressure value. At the starting level, it will be in 0.02 megapascal. So which means the device is in good condition. If it exceeds or below the 0.02 megapascal, we need to troubleshoot the device. It means maybe the inner wire may be damaged or the outer connecting tube. At the starting level, I told you right, the outer connecting knob may be damaged. So at the time we can able to replace the tube and we can able to replace the air filter, then the device will be in good condition. So you can able to see here. So I'm gonna increase it. So I'm gonna reduce it. the suction power. So I remove the power cord. Once again I will tell you the components of the device: the compressor motor and the indicating knob. So the pressure suction power outlet and the regulating knob to increase the pressure, and then turn and off switch. So there is nothing, any electrical components present in the device. If you can able to clearly understand about this process, we able to train it. Okay. So the reservoir bottle has a capacity of 1000 ml. Okay. Inside that we have the cylinder like structure. So if the capacity, if the total capacity to the top level, the cylinder will get upwards, and then the suction will stops. Okay. So now let me assemble it. Fixed correctly. So yes, I fixed it. So now let me scrutinize this screws. Yes, I tied all the screws. So let me check the device is working or not. Once again. So device is running. So here you can able to see 502 MPa megapascal. So device is in good condition. Once again I will clearly tell you the parts. The indicator knob, the unit is megapascal. So the suction outlet, so the regulating knob which is used to increase or decrease the pressure, suction power. So the turn and off switch. So the reservoir bottle. So this bottle has a capacity of 1000 ml. You can able to see here. And then, so we here we have the two outlets. One is for giving the vacuum inside the bottle. Another is for connecting to the patient, which means the catheter part. So this tube is to connected to the patient side. So here only we can able to connect the catheter. So we have two different sizes of catheter. So very thin size catheter and the slightly larger one. So the larger one for the adults, the smaller one for the infants or babies. So like this, we can able to connect the catheter. You can able to see here. This patient side has to be connected in the in part. So here you can able to see the two indication in and out. So in the in portion, we can able to connect the patient side tube, and in the out portion, we can able to connect this air filter connection. The air filter has to be connected like this. So now we need to connect this portion here. One end of the tube has to be connected here, and the other end has to be connected here. Okay. So this is how we need to assemble the device. Now we can able to understand clearly about this suction pump. So hope so you can able to understand clearly about this suction fulcrum unit. So thank you for listening.